what I've always heard sometimes is, well, you're going to get the outcast. You're going to get people that don't fit in anywhere else. Is that really the clientele that you attract? Or what type of people can people expect to meet and see in your gym?
Just normal, everyday people. We have a few people that are kind of oddballs. I guess that's me included. But for the most part, it's normal people, housewives, police officers, firefighters, just everyday people. They all have one thing in common. They want to be fit. They want to extend their life. They want to have a healthy lifestyle. And it's just CrossFit.
So what I'm not going to see when I come into your gym, and please tell me this is going to be true, I'm not going to see you sporting some little bitty bikini underwear and all oiled up standing in front of a mirror. Please tell me that's not going to happen.
No, we have no mirrors in my gym. We have no mirrors in my gym. Now, I do have a kilt that I work out in every now and again, and I don't wear boxers. I don't wear no underwear underneath it, and I only wear that when we do knees to elbows.
So, wait. All right. So, and that's kind of what we found at our gym, really, is we don't have kilts, actually. I'm not going to wear one, but I wear a Speedo because, you know, I think I look good the less clothes I wear. But the big thing is, we see what we actually find out at our gym and from the people that we train is that they're not so much about what their background is, it's what their goals are. And that's kind of the common thread that brings people together. I've seen the most, you know, we have a guy that trains with us who's a pretty good financial planner. And he had his Christmas party last year, and we had our Christmas party, and he showed up to ours in a suit and a tie, and he couldn't get it off quick enough. And it wasn't because he was embarrassed to be wearing a suit and tie. He just had more fun at our Christmas party. So, you know, when you bring those type of people together in a community environment, you see some pretty magical things happen. Do you have some pairings that you wouldn't normally see in society at your gym of people that are beginning to hang out and do things together outside of the gym?
I don't know so much because we're still kind of new that they're doing things outside of the gym. I have some people that come in and work out together, and they will go outside. Now, I have personally, we go out and do things with me and my wife go out and do things with other couples. But I don't know so much right now, but it probably will be down the road because we're still, what are we, 6 months? 6 months old. I think it'll work that way eventually. I don't know. Everybody gets along, and it's just everybody has a good time and works hard. We can sit back. If you're finished and you're with your workout and you're kind of hanging out and the next group comes in and you want to cheer them on or make fun of them, I don't care, either way. And, you know, it just kind of, we got school teachers, you know, I got a principal, I got a pastor, which, as a matter of fact, I made the pastor's wife throw up.
You're going to hell for that. You do realize this, right? Yeah, there's a special place carved out for you when you make a preacher's wife throw up.
I was told that I get like one extra lap in the lake of fire for making a pastor's wife throw up. So I don't know. But, you know, it's just awesome.